Today we will discuss EOQ model with finite replenishment rate. It is also referred as economic production quantity model. Here we assume finite replenishment rate as P and the demand rate as R. To avoid shortages, we assume that replenishment rate P is larger than the demand rate R. The model is formulated with following assumptions. First assumption, system deals with single item. Demand rate R is known and constant. Replenishment rate is finite at P units per time unit with P greater than R. Shortages are not allowed and lead time is zero. Q is replenishment size, which is a decision variable. T is a cycle time, a decision variable. We know that Q and T are related as Q is equal to R into T, that is demand into cycle time. The inventory holding cost H per unit per time unit and ordering cost A per order is known and constant during the period under review. So this is how the one cycle can be visualized. At T equal to 0, we start the system. So let us start with the 0 inventory level at T equal to 0. The production starts at this point of time at the rate of P units per time unit and demand occurring at the rate of R units are satisfied from the production. The production continues till Q is equal to R into 2 units are produced. T1 is the time at which production stops. Now from the accumulated inventory, the demand is satisfied at the rate of R units. Capital T is the cycle time at which the inventory level reaches to zero. So we have production phase from 0 to T1, during which production is there and demand is getting satisfied. So slope of the line is P minus R. From T1 to T, we have known production phase, and from the accumulated inventory, demand is getting satisfied, and so the slope of the line is negative R. Now, the differential equation during the production phase is rate of change of inventory at any instant of time t is given by P minus R. So dq of t by dt is equal to P minus R between 0 to T1. During non-production phase, rate of change of inventory is negative R. So dq t by dt is equal to negative R during T1 to capital T. Initial condition is at T equal to 0, Q of 0 is equal to 0. At T equal to T1, maximum inventory is accumulated and that should be equal to Q, which is also equal to R into T. And at T equal to T, we don't have any inventory in the system, so Q of T is equal to 0. Now with this boundary conditions, the solution of differential equation is Q of T is equal to P minus R into T between 0 to T1 and R into T minus T between T1 to T. We know that the function QT, that is inventory at any instant of time T, is continuous function of time T. So we have Q of T1 equal to P minus R into T1 is equal to R into T minus T1. Simplification of this gives T1 is equal to RT by P and RT is Q. So T1 is equal to Q by P. Hence, average inventory in the system per time minute is I1 of Q is equal to 1 upon T integration 0 to T QT DT. Now, inventory we are storing in production phase and non-production phase. So, we have 1 upon T integration 0 to T1 QT DT during the production phase, and during non-production phase, it is integration T1 to T QT DT. Simplification of this 0 to T1, P minus R into T DT per time unit, so 1 upon T gives you Q square upon 2 PT into 1 minus R by P. That has been labeled as equation 3. And 1 upon T integration T1 to T R into T minus T DT is R into T minus RT by 2 minus RT1 plus RT1 square by 2T. That is labeled as equation 4. Now, if we add up, because we want total inventory, so we add equations 3 and 4, we get total inventory in the inventory system during production phase and non-production phase as Q by 2 into 1 minus R by P. Hence, the total cost of an inventory system per time unit is TCQ, which is sum of inventory holding cost and ordering cost. Inventory holding cost is H into number of units in the inventory system plus ordering cost, that is ER by Q. So, total cost of having Q units is H into Q by 2 into 1 minus R by P plus AR by Q. You can see that this total cost function is well defined, continuous indefinitely. So, using classical optimization, the optimum value of Q equal to Q0 can be obtained by setting first order derivative of total cost with respect to Q equal to 0, and that simplifies to Q0 is equal to under root 2AR upon H into 1 minus R by P. Here Q gives optimum value as second order derivative of total cost with respect to Q is 2AR upon Q cube, and all these parameters are non-negative. So, second order condition is non-negative, and that suggests that the total cost obtained by Q0 is minimum. Putting value of Q0, we get total minimum cost per time unit as under root 2AHR into 1 minus R by P. And cycle time, once Q is known, we can have cycle time as Q by R, and simplification gives 2A upon HR into 1 minus R by P whole square root. Now, this is actually a special case. First note says if P is equal to R, that means replenishment rate is equal to demand rate, then replenishment will have to take place continuously. And if it is getting continuously, then there will be neither a carrying cost nor replenishment cost. If replenishment rate P is infinite, then the formulation reduces to classical order quantity model. Thank you.